Good evening, everybody. A whole new Nail Talk Live Show International. Tonight, it's all about gels. Cool nails, awesome designs because of the transparency of the different gels that we use. Different shapes, of course. But before we get into all of that, let's get started. So of course, I am not alone. It all feels so sad like this, huh? Pepijn is sitting next to the desk between our trainers. So welcome.
Hi. Hello.
Everyone.
Yes,
hi.
I chose the best spot in the house. Well, the second best spot, perhaps. And this makes it a little bit easier to really discuss the various techniques that we're going to see,
absolutely,
the various nails. And we're just going to try a little bit of a different setup. Mm-hmm. So, but that doesn't mean that Jessica isn't very important, of course, I guess.
No, and you're close by. So it's nearly, well, maybe a couple of meters, and then I'm next to you. So this show is all about different gels, and we have different kinds of trainers who are showing us, giving us demos, and showing us different techniques, and beautiful art, of course. So the first trainer that is going to show us something is Katarina. And Katarina from the Ukraine, our beautiful little trainer, as we call her, a little friend, is going to show us a cloudy nail, a new kind of technique. Well, let's go see. So Katarina is making her nail, building a nail with power gel, and she's now making the elongation with power gel clear, and just blending it in.
Yeah, she's really creating only the shape,
yep,
of the nail.
Only the shape.
And of course, the form is cut totally in precision because you see that the flaps are away.
Yeah. And then power gel nude to make the nail bed, of course.
Yeah, it's going to be a reverse nail, I believe.
Yeah.
And the first layer is very thin, of course, because
yeah,
she wants to make she wants to create an inlay.
Yeah. Beautiful, cool inlay design.
Yeah, it's a very nice design.
Yeah.
Well, I especially like the last step.
Yeah, yeah. That's what I
was
love,
like,
yeah,
when I saw it, like, huh? Yeah. But that will come later.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
Oh, she changes brushes.
Yeah, yeah, that's nice.
Yeah,
to see.
That's really nice to see.
Great brush.
But why does she do that, do you think?
With a bigger brush, like an acrylic brush, it's a little bit more flexible, so you can create a nice,
a soft,
sort
of arch.
Upper arch, yeah.
And now she's painting in with a glass gel, glass polish blue, and giving different kind of depths.
Yeah,
so
very
little
nice
shells.
Oh, shells, right.
And again, the blue glass polish.
So did she harden? Did she cured it?
I think she cured it.
Yeah.
And this glass gel is also it becomes very dark. It gives a lot of shade as
yeah,
well. The cyan. I always forget
cyan. And she's using two kinds of glass polishes,
yeah,
because
nice,
the cyan and the blue. And the blue is really darker blue.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Like
I see
the
yeah,
royal blue. It's beautiful. And of course, it gives a kind of sea feeling,
yes,
like this, huh?
Yeah.
So now, I believe the standard builder clear.
Yeah, because it's so beautiful and transparent.
Yeah.
I love to work with standard builder gel clear for inlays.
Now you use the Detailer 3, yeah, to cap
yeah,
your design,
yeah,
Sirisa.
That was exactly what I was thinking.
Yeah.
But this brush is also good, yeah, because it's very sharp.
I use this one
and
too,
small.
Always.
But the Detailer 3 I prefer. But that's.
Yeah. Yeah,
just
I have to say, I tried it with the Detailer 3 recently, and it really works like a charm.
Yeah.
It's just
true,
super.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Especially in the corners, Deborah,
yeah,
because
mm-hmm,
you can pull it to the corners
yeah,
of the smile line, and
yeah,
it's like
true,
over
yeah,
and done. But here goes
yeah,
the
yeah,
mystery.
Yeah, yeah. Watch this.
And that smile line, it's beautiful, beautiful.
Yeah, but it's not about the smile line today, it's
yeah,
about this.
No, I know, true, true. This part is really great.
So this is Ernild's paint, white, that she's going just to dab.
Yeah.
And then with her Ernild's gun.
And it's a wet layer of gel that she's dabbing it in.
So it's kind of like wet-ish, huh?
Nice, eh?
And then just, well, give them swirls. And it really gives a sea
effect.
A sea feeling.
The foam from the sea. Yeah.
Yeah.
Cool, huh?
From the waves. Nice. Cool. Very great. That's nice.
Yeah, I think you have to be careful that you don't overblow the air with the air gun, because otherwise it's gone
everywhere. Well, that gives a different effect.
Yes, a cloud in your face.
A cloud in the
rain. Nice.
So cool.
Super. Yeah. Really. Yeah, it's like an easy way of marbling.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah. True.
Great.
It's so cool.
Yeah, I was, when I first saw this, I was like, what is she doing?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So
yeah.
Did you ever try this technique?
Yes.
Did you ever did this?
I did. The same, yeah. I wanted to show this one in a demo, but we didn't have the time for this a long while ago. So it did exactly the same thing, but only not under total surface.
Oh.
So, yeah.
Oh, perhaps we can tape that demo still another time.
Yeah, maybe we could.
So the wet air nails paint inside the gel, won't it affect anything when it cures?
No.
No, I don't think so. Because No. It's only a little bit, and it's. I think it's going to melt together with the gel and cure. And air nails paint is easily cured. So
yeah, that's true.
I think that's
and
true.
It's
not
such
a problem.
Thin layer, so
and it's of course such a small amount.
Yeah, of course. Yeah.
So that makes it easier. The air nails paint, I am discovering though that the air nails paint is very multifunctional.
Yeah, true.
Because of course we can do it with air nails. We saw now the wet and wet blowing technique.
I don't know how to say this, but
wet blow.
It's nice.
Yeah.
windy technique. But you can also really use it for aquarelle and for painting, eh, Jessica?
Yeah, you can make awesome, really beautiful, transparent-like looking flowers using the air nails paint. Because they're so thin, it's really cool that you can really put a spot, like a petal of a flower, and then removing by just tipping into that drop of paint.
Yeah.
And just sucking it out, and then with the detailer 3, for instance, and then you have just a transparent drop of petal, and then high sharp lines, just as an outline.
Yeah.
Beautiful.
But Jessica, the normal paint you can't mix with gel, but you can mix the airbrush paint with gel.
Yeah.
Is that possible?
Oh, I don't know. Never.
Because
never
she
tried
put
it.
The airbrush paint in the gel.
Yeah.
And
I think it's
on
possible.
Very good.
Yeah,
it sinks in a little
that's
bit, I think.
Of course, because but paint is always water-based.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And also, the air nails paint is water-based. So to really mix it
together,
I wouldn't do that. It would separate.
Yeah.
And it would also influence adhesion.
Mm-hmm.
It will make the nail brittle.
Yeah.
But if you use it as a small detail, then it stays there, kept between the gel.
The layers, yeah. Okay.
Also because the paint is thinner than the gel, so it sits in there.
Yeah.
Anywho, of course, today it's all about the different types of gels. Mm-hmm. So, what are your favorite gels? Let's start with you, Deborah.
Oh, I have quite a lot, actually.
But you can choose one.
Oh, one. Oh.
No, not one, two.
No, that's too difficult. back in the days, I always liked flash gel thick. That was my uber favorite. But now I like power gel and builder clear, then, if I can choose two.
Okay, and what did you find so attractive in flash gel?
Well, the self-leveling structure is self-leveling, and it stays on its place very, very good. The adhesion is very great, so no air, no nothing. No, I really love the gel, and it was very fast to work with, easy to file. Yeah.
Because of course it has a big, a bigger amount of mess.
Yeah. Yeah. Mm.
It is not the easiest gel to work with, the flash gel, because you really have to move your brush in order for the shear within the gel to start moving, and then it starts to self-level.
Yeah,
if you stop
perfect.
With this movement, then it also stops to self-level.
Yeah. Yeah.
So it really is a gel with a certain way of using
it. Yeah, but
gel.
I loved it. No, I still love it, actually. But
well, there are many people that love it. Mm-hmm. What is your favorite gel?
Well, I have to say power gel, of course. And the reason that I love power gel so much is because I'm a teacher. I'm more of a teacher than really a nail stylist. So when I work, I want to show people what I am doing. And I want to have the time to explain everything. So power gel stays on its place if I give it a little push, it goes a little bit the other way. So I want to show my students that. And I can do that perfect with power gel. So that's why I really love power gel. If I worked in a salon before, I think I would prefer acrylics. But for me, to teach something.
From an educational point of view, of course, working with power gel is very handy because you are able to show your students and other technicians exactly what happens when you push it the wrong way or the right way. And I also think that beginning nail technicians, that it's easier for them to recreate that nail.
Absolutely.
That's true.
Okay, well, that means that I'm right. Jessica, what is your favorite gel?
Well, I agree with Deborah. I have the same power gel, and because I do reverse French with the standard Builder Clear, I love it. So yeah, I agree. But do you know who also loves power gel?
No, but I want to tie into what's your favorite gel, because I think deep down in your heart, your favorite gel is black liner gel.
Of course. Yeah, I agree. You're right. How could I forget, huh? Yeah. And also the black liner gel. But who also likes and loves power gel is our very own Natalia. And Natalia is going to show us a demo and make a beautiful, cool nail. So let's go have a look.
Yes, so Natalia is going to make a very trending nail at this moment. She's going to start with the Power Gel Clear from the tube, and she's using the double brush to make the elongation.
I really love that brush.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I haven't tried it.
Oh my God. Oh my God.
What am I saying? I'm so sorry.
Please remind me. So she covers the complete natural nail also, because now she's going to work with an opaque color.
Yeah, absolutely.
White.
And it's stronger, because it's stronger.
Yeah.
Because the white power gel is a little bit softer, so you need a stronger gel underneath it.
Okay.
And for the adhesion.
Also.
Because, of course, clear adheres better than white.
Yeah.
But why is she using white?
That's a total trend right
it's
now.
It's so trendy. Yeah.
Oh, I missed it.
Oh, it's great. I love it. When I saw this demo for the first time, I was completely in love.
Still so milky nail beds.
Nice.
It's now trendy.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, so second application, because of course, especially when you work with white, you have to work relatively thin.
Yeah, absolutely. But not too thin, because otherwise it will not be as... it's going to be transparent.
Yeah, okay. But don't build up the thickness in one layer, because
never go
thicker than 1.8 millimeters of power gel in one application, because the light has to penetrate.
Yeah, but it's the same with the nude and extender.
Yeah,
exactly.
So it's always...
Yeah, it's harder
nail
to cure.
Nail bed is always into...
Clear, you can build as thick as you want, but don't do that at home.
And check your white before you pinch it, because otherwise you pull out the product.
Yeah.
You push it out.
Okay, so wait.
Yeah.
The nail is filed.
Yeah.
And now?
She's going to use the Cat Eye Green Emerald.
Love this color.
Oh,
this is so
the
nice.
The best.
And she's creating a border kind of.
She's going to make it like a 3D. You know?
Yeah, but the contrast is quite heavy.
Yeah, it's great.
But it's the best. It's absolutely stunning.
She's using Jessica's choice, I believe.
Yeah.
No, Katerina.
Oh, Katerina's choice.
Yeah.
Ah, thank you.
To make the snorriges.
The moustache.
The curls of the moustache.
Because it's such a tiny brush.
And she is now focusing on repeating the shape of the smile line, then with
absolutely.
The green.
And now she's
then a little
using
magnet.
The bottom of the crystal
smart.
Tip holder. That's a magnet in it.
Yeah.
To get the magnified cat eye effect.
Yeah.
Of course, it's now cured.
Yes.
But that is the whole, as we say in Holland, kickshaus of this design.
Yeah. And so is she going to fill this in with the Power Gel Clear to make that 3D effect. And because you have that very nice magnetism underneath, you get a very cool effect from
and
it.
Magnetism, yeah.
Yeah, it's like a 3D French meets the inlay nail meets the...
Yeah, really
it's
cool.
So hot and cool right now.
Yeah, well, it's just a 3D nail, but
I love this.
Different colors.
Yeah.
So again,
this
file.
I still don't know what I have to think of the white nail bed.
Strange, eh?
You have to get used to it. With a little bit of strass.
Well, maybe in a whole design.
Rhinestones fix everything in Deborah's world. So she's repeating with the same white power gel.
Yes, absolutely. Also not a too thick layer.
And the trick, of course, with a 3D nail like this is don't make too many different 3D elements.
No.
Keep it simple, keep it serene. Yeah, but also too much work.
Also,
because you have to file all those smile lines again and again.
Yeah. If you want to do it like that, then you should do like Cerisa did, make it a little bit...
color blocking.
Yeah.
And it's already almost perfect.
Nice. Look at that.
Her application skills are just amazing.
Beautiful. Yeah.
Okay, so I'm curious to see the result.
Yeah, it's beautiful. Really beautiful. The effect from the green is so beautiful.
That's very
beautiful.
Nice.
Yeah, I really love it.
Yeah.
Beautiful.
So how do you like the white nail bed now, Pepijn?
Well, cool. Yeah.
It's like a white gel polish.
Yeah, it's just cool. That.
With
a
belt of
it's
green
cat eye.
Absolutely
gorgeous nail.
Yeah. It's very cool.
Yeah. Yeah, it is.
It's very cool.
Yeah.
When I'm watching this, the only thing that comes to mind is, of course, I like the contrast between the depth of the cat eye versus the opacity of the white.
Yeah, yeah.
But why don't we then want to paint on the white nail bed? Because that would make it easier when we do the refill.
No, it's more beautiful. This is more beautiful. And more flawless.
Yeah.
Yeah. And while I'm saying this, I realize that, of course, we now have the wall.
Yeah, yeah.
And
yeah.
The height that we
you need
up against.
Yeah, 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 yeah. Absolutely.
But if you do this at home, make sure that you do clear underneath your white application, not only to ensure adhesion, but especially to make it easier for yourself to do the refill. Because then you file away the white, and then you have the bumper in between the natural nail and the white, so that you know when you are when you have to stop filing. If you put the white straight on the natural nail, it may saturate the nail plate, it may also color the nail plate a little bit, discolor the nail plate, that's a better choice of words. And then the natural nails look like they have leukonychia.
And it's stronger also.
And it's stronger, although that is relative, because the addition of the pigment doesn't have a huge impact on the strength of the gel.
Well, or the flexibility.
Yeah, but for me, I found out that it was a bit softer than the clear.
Mm-hmm. Okay, yeah.
Such a cool effect,
yeah,
huh, guys?
Yeah, we love the cat eyes.
And it's
yeah.
a different way also.
I love the cat eyes too.
Absolutely.
That's why we have a commercial waiting for you, showing you all of our beautiful cat eyes. Mm. So beautiful. And of course, this collection is our number two collection. This collection has a little bit of sparkles and shimmers in and are awesome if you go over with the Extreme Matte Top Gel that we have. Beautiful, beautiful. Don't you agree, guys?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Oh.
We love cat eyes.
Oh, yeah.
And I can tell you a little secret. Other cat eyes are on their way.
Oh, my
Very
Lord.
Great ones.
Shush.
So, of course, Sylvana is with us, as always, and so Sylvana is going to show us some things that she found on social media. Hi, Sylvana.
So, I was scrolling on TikTok again, and I found something completely different. I found some real crazy shapes. So, let's see. Well, when I was watching it, it remembered me about my nails from a long time ago that Risa made with me. Do you remember it, Risa?
Yes, of course, Sylvana. I remember that. It was from, I think, 6 or 7 years ago. It was a very nice day and a little bit of a crazy day. It took us hours and hours and hours, and you just were the, I don't know how to say that in English.
Swirl.
We call that a vocal in Dutch, but
corkscrew.
Screw, yeah. So yeah, it was nice. It was big fun to do it, but I remember you break your nail in 3 days, I think, like that. So it was good for 3 days. Very nice. Nice to see.
These nails were so horrible. It broke a day later. And well, it was nice to try, but that was it. So I'm not finished. I have another video for you about a crazy shape. So, well, a perfect name for this shape is a scissor shape, I guess. So weird, and I wouldn't try it. So let's get back to Jessica and Pepijn.
I actually see the possibilities of that nail shape.
Really?
Especially when she started to pinch it, it opened up, unfortunately. Yeah. But when she pinched it, then it really became a stiletto with, like, let's say, an open.
But that's true. Yeah.
And that for a photo, and then with a big rhinestone in between the points.
Yeah. Oh, the rhinestones for Deborah, of course.
Wow. Yeah. What did you think? I mean, yes.
Okay. If you put it like that, Pepijn, maybe it's interesting, but like how Sylvana showed, I don't like it that much. So, next up, because what I really like is the next demo that is coming up. And Sabine from France is going to work with sculpting gels. Sirisa, do you work a lot with sculpting gels?
To be honest, only in class. Because a sculpting gel, it's really, I think, for professionals, really professionals. Because it's not self-leveling, so you have to mold your shape. You have to get used to that to become a pro. So I think it's a very nice gel. But for to create a wall, it's actually very great because you can work very sharp for a gel, as sharp as a gel can be. So it's a very nice demo. Hope you like it.
Yeah, I agree. And I really love to see how Sabine is working with this sculpting nail because it's really hard to make even a nail bed. Don't you agree, Sirisa?
Yeah. Oh, it's perfect for a nail bed, but very difficult.
Yeah.
Very difficult.
Yeah.
And when I have that class, I always try for one day to find my own way to create it. But I think in this video, Sabine show us the perfect way to create this nail bed because I always stick with that way to create that nail bed, and it's very 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 hard, really.
So, you are going to walk us through, aren't you, Suris? So
yes.
Let's go have a look.
So she already started with a sculpting fiber clear to make the extension, the elongation, and also the base layer on the nail.
Again, for adhesion.
And also for the adhesion.
Yeah.
It's very nice because then your gel is knowing where it can run to.
Yeah. It also borders where it runs to because it prevents from seepage into the cuticle.
True.
So it's really a good idea.
A good
so
way.
This is the
sculpting
The sculpting gel.
The sculpting gel. And you can see it almost looks a little bit like power gel. But then you have to pick it up with your brush out of the jar and then place it on the nail. And you can see that she's holding on the contact.
And then
and now she's pushing away with her brush.
Border.
Yeah, with a flat brush. So that's very interesting to see.
Yeah. And this is the border, as you say.
Yes,
the
this
border.
Is directly the border. Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
I thought
that's
she
smart.
It was a mistake.
But it's a great product.
Yeah.
Product that
Yeah, but you need a straight brush. That's because it's wider.
Absolutely.
I would think to start now with my application behind the border, but she's starting from the cuticle downward.
Yeah, she's building it to the border.
And is that because of the gravity that it helps to sink there?
Yeah, well, she's going to warm it up close to the cuticle. She's going to warm up her gel, and then she can
smooth it out evenly.
Yeah, she's pulling it to the front, and she keeps her contact with the brush flat.
Yeah, not with the tip of the brush, with the
completely
belly of the
flat.
Brush.
Yeah. And you can see it looks very easy, very satisfying, but it's very difficult.
Oh yeah, this product.
To get it even.
No, it's very difficult to keep the products in place. So in the because you have you take it a little bit, you take it with you.
Yeah, you pull it with you while working.
Yes.
So the difficulty is that it stays where you originally put it.
True. Yeah.
Okay. Well, then you have to show me that once.
Yeah, I can do that. Of course, she is filing her wall. Why not?
Yeah. Well, I think it's necessary if you... Well, I understood from you guys that it's always necessary.
Yeah,
to file
I think
wall.
It's always necessary. Yeah. Then she's painting with a gel polish. She's painting her wall. And she is also painting her elongation.
But of course you could use a liner gel.
You can use everything
any
what
other
you
other
like.
Product
yes.
of choice.
Well, no, but because liner gel, this the
oh,
gel
you need a sticky layer.
Has a sticky layer.
Thank you.
Yeah. And you need a sticky layer to go in with the fluffy brush and the pigments.
The chrome pigments.
Fluffy the brushy.
Fluffy the brushy.
Okay, so that's a good thing. So you need a sticky layer.
You need a sticky layer. Yeah. So no.
And if you would undercure liner gel white. Would it leave a sticky layer, or would it still be not enough?
I think you have enough of a sticky layer
but
to hold your pigments
because of the wrinkly effect it could have.
But this is better.
Yeah.
This is better.
Okay.
Yeah. You have more stickiness, and it's actually a very nice design.
Yeah.
This way, it's going to change a lot.
Yeah.
But I love it like this already.
Yeah. It's not staying like this at all.
No. And again, the gel polish.
Yeah. And now you have to really understand your products because because of the effect that you want to create. Yeah.
Okay, so just for our reference, the sticky layer of the whitest white gel polish, then the pigments are fluffed in, and now she's using the whitest white gel polish to create spots.
Spots or any other kind of
things.
Okay.
Shapes you like.
That prep and white?
Yeah. Of course, she was curing and now
the
pigments.
Now.
But the whitest white, it shrunk a little bit.
Yeah.
And that's why you get this really nice effect.
Cool. So the border around the spot is due to the shrinkage of the whitest white,
so
that
it
pulls
it
through semi-transparent and it stays, that's cool.
Yeah, so you need the gel polish whitest white because a liner gel is something different.
Yeah, it stays on its place.
Yeah, I completely understand now.
Could you do this with black too?
No, not for you, no.
I think you cannot see the effect that much, but you have to try, Jessica.
I will.
Perhaps if you would use a neon pigment instead of a
chrome. That's possible. Yeah, that's possible.
Or the chrome, the green, the gold one, more bright colors.
I think you have to have a bigger contrast then.
Yeah, I think so too.
I think it's awesome.
And these are the metal inlays?
Yeah. And that's to give it a little bit of extra.
Cool.
And of course, the standard.
A lot is happening in this.
Yeah, that's
it's
true.
Beautiful,
it's very nice. Yeah. It's very nice. I can understand if you say, well, I think it's a little bit too strange, but I really love it.
I think full set of these. Yeah. Not just one.
But a lot of
set.
People don't like white in a nail.
Yeah, but
I love
white.
It. It's a very nice effect.
Well, I like white in a nail like this. But on the nail bed, I still have to get you.
Yeah.
This I can comprehend.
Well, maybe if you put a little black nail art on it on top, the white nail bed,
crystals.
And some awesome crystals, I think you would appreciate it then.
And it's very nice in this demo. She used, of course, gel polish.
Yeah.
Standard Builder Clear and Power Gel. So it's a nice combination of gels in
all
one
the
nail.
Different gels. Yeah.
That's very nice.
Using all of the gels to its best characteristic.
Yeah.
And then we have the moment.
Supreme finish, of course.
Oh.
A beautiful nail needs a beautiful shine.
Cool.
Yeah, look at this. Very nice.
Metal inlays too. Oh.
Beautiful.
And the other tips.
Great, eh?
Great. Oh, I love them. Oh.
Yeah, and you can play a little bit around with the shapes that you create.
Yeah.
Great.
I didn't know that was possible with the white gel polish on top of the pigment.
Yeah.
And it
Nice. It's something new, something trendy.
You can
find it also on Instagram and everything. Yeah. But in this way, as an inlay, I never saw that before. So
perhaps I should spend a little bit more time on Instagram because some of these trends I didn't really notice.
But of course, that's why we have the international
trainers. Yeah. And Sabine, of course, is our national trainer for France. And as such, a valuable part of magnetic nail design, as are all the trainers. Jessica.
Yeah. Well, I agree, Pepijn. And this trend is shown a lot on the social media. I saw it with swirls. I saw it with Baroque design. So beautiful, beautiful. But I always see it with white. So that's why I thought, maybe let's go black. So a beautiful, beautiful demo from our Sabine from France. But next up is Diana from Russia. And I hope I pronounce it right, Karimova, I believe. And Diana is going to show us a full overlay, again, with the sculpting fiber clear and lots of different other gels. So let's go have a look.
Yeah, so she's going to start with the fiber gel clear, and she's using the competition nail forms.
Yeah, and it's important to mention that what we see, the white, is the
is a tip.
Pretend nail bed.
Absolutely.
Because it's a natural tip that was pushed into the easy trainer.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And she made the allocation now. And now she has the mixed metal flakes, and she's going to do a little fading on top of the nail bed, and also a little bit on the extension.
Yeah.
And she's going further onto the nail bed.
It's like a double fading.
Yeah,
one.
Absolutely. Yeah. And she's going over with the sculpting fiber again.
To really make it inlay.
Yeah. File it a bit and do the base and top on top. A little bit of the blue gloss, and she's going to fade that over the nail surface too, so you get a very great effect with the colors.
It reminds me of Easter eggs. Chocolate Easter eggs.
No, you mentioned it.
Same shape.
Yeah, but also the happy colors.
Yeah, true. The blue, the
again, capping a little bit.
Yeah.
And the non-filing
smoothing
technique.
It out. Otherwise, of course, you would have the bump of the blue, I think.
Yes, absolutely.
Bumpy blue.
And cool she's she's fixing it with the airbrush top. It's a very high shine effect. Yeah, I love it. Very cool for a short nail.
Yeah, I think so too.
Yeah, very nice. You could do it with a lot of mixed metal flakes or other flakes. Or you can use a lot of inlay on this nail. Perfect.
A very nice nail done by Diana Karimova.
Yeah, absolutely.
It was also her first time that she now did a demo here in Nail Talk Live International Show.
Keep continuing, Diana.
And she used our favorite glass, Jessica?
Yeah, our beautiful, beautiful glass polishes. And we have some new glass polishes coming up. So let's go take a look at that beautiful commercial. Do you like them? I love them. Six new colors, and I am sure that we are going to fall in love as we did for the first six ones that we have. So maybe you saw already those little tips who are laying and onto the backgrounds, and we created a collaboration, didn't we, Sirisa?
Yeah, at last we did one, yay! Right?
Yes.
Even we had a little, we have short time to make it. Little did we know, we had more time actually.
Yeah.
But yeah, we did that in a short time, and we keep in contact. And yeah, it was very nice to do with you, Jessica. And thank you, Gillian, also, and Cheyenne.
Yeah, I yeah, we did it all together. So. Again, a dream team, huh? Yeah, we made our very own designs using the beautiful new glass polishes, and I fell in love with some of those colors, oh, instantly, and I hope you do too. So order, order, and be happy as we are. So first in the show, we all agreed that we all love Power Gel. Well, we do in Holland, eh? And Natalia did already, and some of the other demos. But in the UK, it's the same. Next up, Claire. Claire Miles from London is going to show us a beautiful nail made with Power Gel. So Claire is going to work with Power Gel from the tube, and now she's creating the nail bed with the nude color, Power Gel. And with the Kolinsky hair brush.
She works very gently with it.
Yeah,
right?
She does.
Very soft.
Soft strokes.
Yeah, with everything she does, it's
yeah.
Very, very easy and
so light with the product.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Of course, your elongation is already made. There's one layer of really thin clear. And now she is just dapping and blending it out.
With the other side
but
of the brush.
But she does it with the Kolinsky.
Yeah.
So everybody works different, huh?
Yeah.
And it's all okay.
So this is only the
sharpening.
Nude?
Yeah.
Yeah.
This is just the nude. And then the second bowl, and again with that bigger brush.
Yeah.
And I know that you don't work like that.
Yeah, well, she's turning it around later for the to make it airtight.
Yeah, cuticle area. Yeah.
And she first goes over onto the nail bed, yep. Now creating. And then?
Yeah. And now with the other side,
now
she's really pressing it to seal it around the cuticle. Which is very important, huh?
Yeah.
Be careful and also put the tip of the brush between the cuticle and the product.
Absolutely.
Don't put the tip of the brush in the product because then you will push the product into the cuticle.
Yeah. Put it behind the bowl. And
you have to change your directions from your brush for your
and
from
angle
hairs.
The brush, but that is of course brush technique.
Yeah. True. That is true, of course. Yeah. Yeah.
So it's cured and now filing the wall.
Filing the wall.
It comes back every time.
Yeah, I see.
So and now she is painting with the extreme white gel and really smart.
The really smart.
Because
triangle brush.
Yeah, the triangle brush. Yeah.
Yeah.
So really smart because of the smart, sharp edges of the brush and different size. So now she is really painting with the more wider side of that brush. So really smart.
Yeah. When I saw that this, I was like, what?
Yeah.
Why didn't we think of this, Claire?
Yeah, true.
Just thank you, Claire, for your tip and trick.
Yeah.
We're going to all purchase triangle brushes.
Very important.
Yeah. And this is the Glitter Spray Pink Irish. It has bigger shimmers. And I really love that.
Yeah.
Into that wet extreme white. And then now she's adding a little bit of course, chameleon flakes. Because we need those in every design.
Yes,
that's true.
Yeah, absolute
it's a must. Now,
and I think this is building base, maybe
I think
fiber.
So too.
I don't know. Maybe rubber base because it's.
Oh, I think
thicker.
Rubber base.
Yeah, it's more thicker.
Yeah.
And now into that wet rubber base or what it is, now she's putting those beautiful opals, and it's maybe a bit hard to see because it's white on white. But later on, and that gives us really more a spring design look.
Now
the
you can
orange
see
opals. Beautiful, huh?
Yeah, it's very nice.
And it gives really an AB feeling, huh?
True.
Yep.
Because of the pink iris underneath and all of the colors. So, of course, if you see, really look really close, little bullions, a little pearls.
Nice, huh?
Oh, nice.
And then the standard Build-A-Clear, of course.
White.
And also with a bigger.
And now, of course, again, the standard build gel to magnify everything that's lying in that nail.
Yeah, that's also a must-have.
Then you can see.
Yeah, yeah. Well, it works like a magnifying glass.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah,
true. Yeah,
and so many trainers, and you can see all the different countries they use
the same things.
Power gel for the nail bed, standard build, clear to
power
cap.
Gel
so
for the nail bed
perfect.
Is also the
lovely.
Easiest way. Oh,
look
right
at
stones.
That!
Yes. Nice,
and
beautiful.
Great nail.
Yeah, and as you said, of course, we see that everybody's using power gel for the nail bed
because it's by far
the easiest way to do the nail bed.
You can see all countries, we agree with each other.
Yeah, absolutely.
Especially Sabine, but she knows her way with the sculpting gels. And they're also very nice colors because they're total different colors than power gel. So it's very nice to
Of course, you have to find the perfect camouflage color to really enhance the natural nail bed instead of replacing the natural nail bed. Yeah. But this was a soft springtime design.
Yeah, or feminine. Maybe for couples who get married.
Yes, I was also thinking, going to the chapel and we're going to get opals. Anywho, we're going back to
Okay, well, let's talk about something different, because do you know how to find us also? Because we are also on YouTube, and our channel is called Magnetic Nail Talk. So please find us, subscribe, and find all of our different shows, our loose demos, because every demo is cut and loose. And just for a few seconds, minutes, you can see and look back all of the demos that we have shown in Nail Talk Live, the English version, but also the Dutch show that we have. All of our e-workshops are on it. So be prepared and get a whole lot of nailspiration, as Silvana calls it, and be inspired like that. So please find us and subscribe, thumbs up, and have fun. Of course, what also is having fun, who is having fun, I must say, is Magda. And Magda is making beautiful, beautiful nails and showing us awesome techniques. So Magda is next up to show us a beautiful nail that she makes using, I believe, Standard Builder. And who is going to talk us through? I don't know.
Me.
Oh, Sarissa, you are going to walk us through. And I've seen the video up front, and it is really awesome. Don't you agree, Sarissa?
Yeah, well, I agree. And not only the design, but I also love Magda, of course. And this design, it's really, I think it's really, it's my style. It's very clean, very nice, and it's balanced in the end result. So
Yeah, I agree. And the color inside comes back on the upside of our of the nail. But let's go have a look, and you know what we mean then.
Okay, she's gonna make the extension with, make the extension with the Standard Builder clear.
Yeah.
And it's also very nice to make your elongation with this, because you have to really draw your shape, and that's just enough if you want to make
it
in
a very small brush.
Yeah, and a straight
gel.
One
the
as well.
A brush.
Yeah, yeah. But
now
this is very nice because
gel.
she used the angle of the brush to make the shape.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah. Of course, power gel, and using the double brush. And she is first blending the gel on the nail.
Yeah.
And what we saw before, that
Care
was the second part,
the other.
This is the first part, with the way she loved to do it.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and the second bead, I think she used just nudes, because she's working on an artificial nail.
Yeah.
And you don't have to use two colors of gel. But I would choose for a client the extender for this part.
For a softer transition into the skin and the natural nail of the client. Yeah. Yes, I think we all agree.
Yeah, but this is something else, so.
Yeah.
Okay, when she's finished, she's gonna sharpen it up a little bit.
And now?
And then she is coloring in the, the wall.
Wall,
let me see.
Yeah, the border.
The border, thank you. With concentrates black.
And she's also going to use those concentrates now, or glass?
Glass gel.
Yeah, sorry. Yeah. So I was green a little glass. Bit confused. Yeah, she's using a glass gel to she's filling out the whole extension, filling in the whole extension.
Yeah, this is
with a little bit of glass effect.
I can see why you like this.
Yeah, it's very nice. Something I would like to
inlays.
Do.
Yeah.
Special inlay. And she make a little bit of a darker glass gel in the border.
And that's the point where you need a higher border.
A higher border to make your room for, absolutely. Because you want to put the special inlays in there.
Yeah. And that's why she put the special inlays in the middle, because in the sides, the side of the nail, in the side walls, your product and your wall is a little bit thinner.
Yeah, it tapers down, of course. Yeah.
So she has a
little
bit
inlay gold, but also the foil, the gold foil. To the side walls of the nail.
Yeah, so to get a little bit the same effect,
yeah.
but thinner.
But thinner,
Yeah, that's smart.
And
yeah.
of course, the standard builder clear to cap everything.
Of course.
And she's going to file it. Now you think it's already done, but the best is yet to come.
Yeah, it is.
Using Supreme Finish to give it a perfect shine.
Look at that.
Beautiful.
Yeah. Because you use only a little bit of glass gel, it's still transparent.
Yeah,
so that's very nice.
Yeah. It's very transparent.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, fashion sticker to create a jewel.
Love those.
And the jewel is going to match the extension.
Yeah, that's a green
using the same products.
So she's working on top of that nail.
Yeah, very
How
nice.
How does that sticker stay on then?
She's capping the whole surface after she's finished, after she put the rhinestones.
Oh, yeah. So a little bit of all of those elements into that really.
Yeah,
beautiful.
So that's very nice. It's actually the same.
Yeah.
Same as the inlay.
Yeah.
Cool. Mix and match. Yeah, this is a design I really love.
It's a little necklace if you pull.
Yeah.
Yeah, and this color, I think that's very nice, is from the, let me see, it's not on here. It's an rhinestone wheel.
Yeah.
And it matches this color. Amethyst, thank you.
And
then she's capping it a little bit that it stays in place and perfect.
Very nice.
This is also up your alley, yeah?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
Beautiful nail.
I get what you mean with clean. Clean, but still, it has a lot.
Yeah, that is what I love.
It's crisp, sharp.
Yeah.
It's not messy.
No, absolutely. No.
Because sometimes. Yeah, but sometimes you do see nails that have a lot of elements like this nail. And then because there is no coherency in it, it becomes messy and it becomes a whole gajuju.
Yeah, a gajuju, that's right.
You're missing the effect.
Yeah.
Yeah, and that is what I love. If you create something or you create a rhinestone or you use rhinestone, it have to be, you need a purpose to... You have to see why.
It has to have a purpose, yes.
Yeah,
and
that is, with this design, it's
You just cannot throw everything in the nail and
But you could throw everything in the nail 20 years ago.
Yeah, absolutely.
That was the whole Valka game.
That was the whole point about it.
The more the merrier. The more the better. Let's go back to you, yes?
Yeah, I agree. Inside and on the outside. So let's put everything in and then paint everything so you won't see anything of the background anymore. That's how we did it, didn't we?
Yeah.
Next up is Sylvana. Sylvana is going to, because she still has a little bit of socials waiting for us. So Sylvana, I believe ombre nails?
I'm back and let's talk about ombre. Ombre is a very beautiful design, but also very, very different to do it. But I have a few examples for you about ombre. Very pastel colored, so nice. Also, but then another way. Also purple, love purple colors. And this is made with air nails, I think. Very beautiful and like another way. And this is from Melinda. She's the ombre master, I think. And for the last one, also made with air nails. Very beautiful. Deborah and Srisa, do you make a lot of ombre?
Well, in summer I do a lot. Oh, yeah. In winter, not so much, but in summer, like everyone needs an ombre nail. Absolutely, yeah. And you, Srisa?
Yeah, I sometimes create an ombre because it's very difficult to do.
Mm-hmm.
And it's also very difficult to make a nice a nice cuticle
application.
Thank you. Yeah. And if I make an ombre, I want to do that as an inlay, like a baby boom or a collar boom.
Okay.
That's the way I like to make an ombre.
Mm-hmm. I'll have to combine it when you have like a purple on the pinky,
yeah.
And then on the ring finger you have the already it's going to start with a mix of the ombre.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then on the middle finger you put the other way around with the color, and then put the index finger. The color when you put it around. Do you know what I mean?
It's a lot. It's a lot. And a lot of work as well.
It's a lot of work because I tried to do an ombre once and it was terrible. Terrible.
I really love it.
Oh. Did I ever show you
difficult.
The photo?
No.
I burned it.
Oh no.
Really?
Yeah. Come on.
Why?
Oh.
Let's go back to Sylvana.
I love to make ombre with dark colors. That's my favorite. So I hope you have your daily doses of inspiration. Or do we call it inspiration? I'll see you next week.
Yeah, inspiration, still a great word.
It's a new word.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
I think we're already almost at the end of tonight, huh, Jessica?
Yeah.
But who's going to do our last demo?
Yeah, we are, Pepijn. Our last demo is from Oksana Smirnova, and she's from Norwich, UK, and she is going to make to show us how to make one hand. Beautiful set, and she is using as an inlay fast liner gel. Awesome. Let's go have a look.
So she's working on her own hand?
Yeah.
And she's going to start with the fiber gel clear, which is actually in the fiber in the gel range our most favorite gel or
I
most sold gel,
that.
The fiber gels.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. It's not completely transparent, so that's
no.
The thing.
It has the fiber particles in it.
Yes,
but it still has a lot of strength, so you can apply
that's
very
true.
Thin.
Yeah, that's true.
That's great.
Yeah.
Of course, it's always difficult to work on yourself
yeah.
when you're being
yeah.
filmed.
Absolutely.
But the design is really. Just abstraction meets feminine.
Yeah, yeah, true. When I
quite a long elongation.
Yeah. Yeah. But you need it with this design, okay. I think, a little bit of length.
She's fast.
Yeah.
Powered your
white.
White
is
strength again.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah.
With a wooden stick.
Yeah, that you see a lot too.
Yeah?
Yeah, with the rosewood. Yeah.
Why?
Yeah, that's a great question.
Okay.
I tried it before and I was
well,
not so fond
let's
about it.
Let's ask Oksana.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Why
yeah.
are you doing this with the orange wood stick?
Yeah. And now she used, oh, sorry, we are talking together, of course. And I was thinking she used a complete other gel for the second layer.
Mm-hmm.
So she used the power gel and now she's using fiber
gel.
Whites, another white and another white. I don't know why.
Well, it makes
maybe.
It easy. It smooths out easier, of course.
Yeah, that's
the fiber
true.
Gel.
That's true.
And perhaps the coloring is a little bit different.
Yeah. More intense.
It's possible.
Yeah,
no,
yeah.
Yeah.
Power gel
think
is
right.
a little bit more creamy.
Yeah, mm-hmm. yeah.
Fiber gel is a little bit whiter, but still
really
not
white.
Super, super white.
Yeah, that's true. It gives some.
But
like
okay, now
look.
We have the white nail beds.
Look at this to give it more white.
And this is the fast liner gel.
Yeah,
yeah.
Nice. Eh?
This is so cool.
Yeah.
It's almost futuristic.
Yeah.
Yeah. You
and again, those white nail beds, Pepijn, do you love them already?
Well, I'm beginning to.
Yeah.
You're getting there.
I'm getting there, yeah.
So now she's painting in that wall.
The gold liner gel?
Mm-hmm. No, I think it's the color, the color
one
gel.
One coat color gel.
Oh, yeah. One coat color gel.
True,
okay.
True gold.
True gold. And then just
and
blending
the ombre
it
brush.
Out. Mm-hmm. Ombre. So
of course, you could have also done first the gold and then the liner gel over there.
Yeah.
On top
I
of
will
that.
Do that,
yeah.
I think.
Yeah.
But it's a different effect.
Yeah.
Mm. So, what you like.
So, now the first lines are a little bit goldy. That's cool, too.
Yeah.
So, okay.
I love this
power
effect.
Gel clear.
Power gel
yeah,
clear.
This is cool.
Yeah.
It's very nice, actually, that she uses a lot of types of gels.
Yeah. Absolutely.
Yeah.
And you can see everything combines.
Yeah.
So, great. This is a nail I would wear.
I see.
Me too.
Yeah, I can
yeah,
see you
me
wear
too.
This. Mm-hmm.
You
yeah.
too.
But without the gold.
No,
I would
the
wear it just the whites and the transparent.
You need a little bit of gold in
no,
your life.
I don't
sorry.
I would do black.
Well, perhaps a little bit of silver.
That too.
Platinum.
A little bit of silver.
Diamond. That.
Diamond.
Yeah, nice, eh?
Now,
yeah.
The special.
I like it matte also.
Yeah.
Well, I like
but
the
this really now
shines more.
It jumps off of the screen.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It is awesome.
And so cool to use the fast lining gel inside of the nail instead of all the mess around it.
Very fast, easy design if you look at it.
I think so too.
But a great effect.
Yeah, look at that.
Oh, and because those lines are a little bit thicker, it's really giving depth.
I think the shape for me is a little bit too much, but I love the design.
I love it all.
Yeah.
I want it all.
Very nice.
Yeah. But you will need to add rhinestones.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah. Yeah. Duh. There are no rhinestones.
Yeah, but that I'm thinking with the rhinestones.
So. Yeah. So I think we had a blast this
evening.
Yeah,
I think so too.
We had a lot of different ways of creating nails.
Yeah.
So I want to thank you for our discussion.
Thank you too, and thank you, Jessica. Thank you.
And we're going back to Jess.
Yeah, and thank you. And of course, thank you all for watching. And I hope you had fun and get a lot of inspiration from today. So next week, our topic is non-filing. And the non-filing technique is really cool and saves so much time. So I want to thank you again for watching. Please stay safe and let's go out with a blast. Halperpijn says it. And we are going to watch our beautiful, beautiful commercial of the Naughty On My Nails collection now. And I'll see you next week. Bye-bye.